Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is Engineers with the latest updates from the Angular community every week. The testing tooling situation in Angular is up for a change. That's not really new news. We know already since Angular 16 that there is an experimental support for Jest as an alternative to the Jasmine Karma combination. Also, Karma got deprecated and the Angular team was planning to replace it with Webtest Runner. So that means instead of using Jasmine Karma, it's going to be Jasmine and the Webtest Runner. That was the situation in 2023, and it still is the same thing in 2025. The official testing tool is still Jasmine Karma, but there is one difference, namely that the Angular team is also looking into supporting Vitest instead of Jest. And last week, one PR came out, which has also been merged. The PR is about providing a migration from Jasmine to Vitest. After that PR got merged, a lot of others like that followed. So it looks like that Vitest made it, but we are still missing an official confirmation. So I reached out to Mark Thompson and asked him for an official statement. And here I like to quote him. The only context that we can provide is that the team has been in meaningful discussions to move towards a final decision, but this should not be seen as our final choice at this time. So it's still undecided, and by the way, this is about the official testing tool support from the Angular team. There is also NX, which is an alternative to the Angular CLI, and that one has been providing support for Jest and Vitest for quite a long time. And we stay with testing. Playwright, the most used end-to-end testing framework, was released in version 1.56 and it brought some upgrades to its AI capabilities. It comes with three different agents, where the first looks at your application and generates a test plan. The second agent is the implementer, and the third one is called the healer. So it fixes those bugs coming from the second one. For further information, check out the official video by Debbie O'Brien. And of course, we also had a lot of community content, for example, from Milosz Rutkowski from House of Angular, and he wrote quite a detailed article on server-side rendering. He spends quite some time explaining why or in which cases we want to use it. The main ones are definitely search engine optimization and initial loading performance. Then he moves on to the different modes, incremental hydration, and even goes beyond by discussing analog chairs. And we also got the second part of Julian Jandl's article on LCP, which focuses more on practical insights. The first part was already the main feature in Engine News 2533. And that's it. I wish you a nice week. See you in the next episode. Goodbye.